Ora si registrerà la conferenza.
Welcome and thanks in advance for joining today's webinar from GE Healthcare about automated breast ultrasound. Let me first give a special thanks to our speaker, Dr. Scaperotta, and let me start with a short introduction. Dr. Gianfranco Scaperotta is a radiologist dedicated to sonology and breast imaging. Currently, he is the head of the breast imaging unit of the Foundation IRCCS National Cancer Institute of Milan in Italy. He graduated in medicine and surgery at the University of Milan in 1995 and received the degree in radiology at the same university in 1999. He received this specialization in the Department of Diagnosis and Treatment of the National Institute for Study and Treatment of Cancer, with dedicated focus on breast imaging. During this time, he worked as well in the Department of Radiology in the European Institute of Oncology in Milan. From the 2000, he served as medical director at the Unit of Diagnostic and Interventional Breast in the Foundation IRCCS National Cancer Institute of Milan, where he is holding since December 2011. The position of the head of the breast imaging unit. In 2002, he concluded research at the research center at Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston. Dr. Scaperotta has been invited as a speaker, moderator, and auditor in many national and international breast conferences. And as well, he is the author of many scientific publications. So, with this, I will hand over now to Dr. Scaperotta, and we are very much looking forward to hearing the lecture.
Good morning everyone. Thank you to GE to invite me to speak about our experience with the Abus Invenia and experience with the automatic breast diagnosis in ultrasound. So I speak to you about the problem of the use of ultrasound, the normal activity in diagnosis, in the breast diagnosis, in the breast, in the breast research, in the breast unit that I work every day. So we speak about the problem of breast density and the use of ultrasound. We know that breast density is a very important problem on the breast image and breast screening because sensitivity of mammography decreases depending on the breast density. For example, in this study of Kolb et al., it's possible to see that the sensitivity of mammography decreases from 98% to 48% depending on the breast density. Moreover, breast density is an independent risk factor for developing of breast cancer. In fact, the risk increases from 4 to 6% for 4 to 6 times over lifetime. We know from literature that ultrasound increases the detection rate, and in that scenario could be a multimodal screening with mammography and ultrasound, which would bring the detection rate from 4 per thousand with only mammography to 7 per thousand with the additional ultrasound. To data, there are a lot of studies aimed at defining the possibility rule of tomosynthesis and MRI in the screening pathway. For example, the study of Tagliafico in Italy, the name is Astound, about ultrasound or tomosynthesis, and the study of Christian Kuhl, for example, about MRI. MRI has a very high sensitivity, is the best in sensitivity for the diagnosis in the breast cancer, but there are important problems related to accessibility, cost, contrast medium, and the presence of many false positive results. Instead, the tomosynthesis increases sensitivity and also specificity, but reducing the false positive, but there are problems with extremely dense breast. In the dense breast situation, the sensitivity is the same and don't decrease that, for example, in MRI. So given that ultrasound increased detection rate, where are the critical issues that prevent us from proposing the screening mammography program? Is the question. First, all the time, the problem for the time, and I speak to you about the time and the problem of the time, the reproducibility, because this ultrasound is an operator-dependent procedure, the false positive result, and the cost. Some problem is important problem, and so the problem about the use the ultrasound in the program, in the screening program. For example, in Italy, it's impossible to propose the use of ultrasound for all patients in a screening program. Okay, in the past, we try the possibility to use the automatic breast approach, breast ultrasound approach, and precisely to try to resolve the critical issue that an automatic ultrasound system has started to be evaluated. The system is ultrasound is acquired with a standardized repeatable procedure by training technology, one quarter medium, and so it relays the radiology from the acquisition of the image with an important saving time because the reporting can be made later by radiology in the second time, no in the real time during the procedure. The system, the Invenia ABUS system by GE, is an important machine that uses this approach in automatic approach. An ultrasound scan station connected to a specific linear transducer with a wide field of view that allows to cover an area of 15 per 16 centimeter with a thickness of 6 centimeter and a frequency of 5 to 14 megahertz. The system allows to acquire 100 or 2D mode and B mode, traditional B mode images that are converted in 3D image in second time by multiplanar reconstruction. There are three standard scans, central, lateral, and medium, but other scans can be added in case of big breast, for example, in particular situation during the normal activity in the clinical approach. This system has been tested in screening program in the past by the important group, by Tabar, this study, the name is Somosai study. And so has been tested in screening program, and we can see this important study because there are improved the sensitivity and improved the specificity. In a multicenter observational perspective study, they compare the automatic ultrasound multimodal approach to mammography alone, a normal screening, a normal situation. The result is very interesting. They increased in detection 1.0 cancer for 1,000 screening women with a significant increase in sensitivity to 26% in medium. And the cancer are mostly invasive and node negative in 93%. It's a very important aspect. It's important to for the diagnosis because it's possible to see the very, very small cancer without lymph node co-involvement approach. In 87% of cases, they are less than 2 centimeters. There are some problems, however, the record rate increase, and so we have a number of false positive, and so is important aspect to use the automatic approach in a clinical setting, but I think in the screening setting is very important. There are many other work about ABUS in a screening program and all conclude very favorably. The additional ABUS to mammography in women with breast improved invasive breast cancer detection rate with an acceptable recall increase. And what about the problem with the automatic approach? For us, for our experience in my hospital, we have the automatic breast is simple, is innovative, intuitive procedure. There is the possibility to panoramic view. There is a possibility of reproducibility, height compliance, and low cost. There are some problems for particular approach in a clinical setting, for example, axilla, sovraclavicular approach, inframammary fold. There are no possibility to modulate the exam. Lack of colored opera is important. Is important to prepare the technician to make a study and to make a procedure. What about the cost? In the past, we spoke about the cost, the problem of the cost of ultrasound. So for us, it's important to understand there is the possibility to use or no the automatic approach in normal screening setting. And so we make a study about the cost. So we recently published a study on applicability of ABUS in screening collaboration with the Luke University, and we have analyzed in particular the cost problem. The Luke University is the economical university in Italy and study the economical approach in health service in general. The aim of study to analyze the potential or area of improvement or optimizing of the current screening program in the panel of technology to be used within the bionics phase. We hypothesize three different scenarios. The normal scenario with the mammography alone is ideal scenario. So second, ideal scenario to use in dense brains the ultrasound for all patients. In Italy, in medium is 30-40%. And so the third scenario is ABUS in additional to mammography in a dense breast, the same percent of patients, 30-40%. Two different phases, screening, diagnosis, and a cancer care inpatient treatment. The final result, our experience, our study. We can see in this table the cost of patient at U1 stage are lower than those of patient at a more advanced stage, in particular in the first years. And we know that the ABUS can increase the detection of cancer at U1 stage. In the second and third years, the costs are the same because there aren't different in follow-up. So, this is a form for us is the core of our study. It's important to understand that in the first year, the cost of diagnosis and treatment for small cancer is inferior than the T1, T3, or T4 stage. So we have a big cancer, the cost is different and improve the problem for the diagnosis and treatment in particular. In the second, third year, no. Because the follow-up is the same independently for the primary treatment. So for us, it's very important. So we remember that in our slide, we spoke about the potential of ABUS to detect the very, very small cancer, T1 stage, not T2 or T3. Okay, the final result were obtained in the sum of the screening phase cost and the cancer care and patient treatment phase expenditure divided into 3 year time horizon. All the scenario analyzed confirmed that 2B scenario with economical saving respect to the AIS scenario, while the other scenario absorbed more research due to need incremental investment. The model showed that the introduction of ABUS in Vinia technology in a screening program could lead to increase in the screening phase expenditure, but cold stimulated significant decrease in the patient care in the cancer treatment phase with a lower national service resource absorption. This is experience in Italy, and the study the problem for cancer screening, in breast cancer screening in Italy. I think in other country, Europe, for example, the situation should be different because it's different the cost, the scenario. But in medium in Europe, the situation is similar, and we for my experience, I don't see the particular difference in Europe for South, for example, South Europe and North Europe. The cost is the same. So for us, the introduction of ABUS in the screening program is cost effective. But we use ABUS only in a screen scenario, screening scenarios. I repeat, no, for us, it's possible to study the possibility to use the automatic breast approach in a clinical setting. For example, in second look procedure after magnetic resonance, for monitoring tumor response to treatment during the chemotherapy treatment in the preoperative setting. We recently published a study on the use of ABUS in the surveillance in the follow-up of patients previously treated for the breast cancer for the normal quadrantectomy approach. And the ABUS can play an important role in the surveillance of women with dense breast previously treated for the breast cancer, in addition to gold standard mammography. In particular, for its cost effective aspect, there are great importance in breast unit with the clinical heavy daily workflow. In our experience, we know that the use the automatic approach is possible in the clinical setting to reduce the time, to reduce the cost, to reduce the workflow in a normal day for in the breast cancer activity. So some case, for example, in this case, it's possible to see the cancer in ABUS approach. It's possible to see the mass, the little mass, and so there are the reconstruction with the ABUS in 3D approach. Other cancer, other very, very small cancer near the areola, very, very small cancer, 5 millimeter, is possible to see in the reconstruction in 3D approach in a normal ultrasound. Other case, other approach, is very important the possibility to see the cancer in 3D reconstruction because it's very intuitive approach, it's very easy to understand there is the problem, there is the a normal aspect of the parenchyma in the breast. So, in conclusion, we think that the application of ABUS are many, not only in the screening program, but also in the clinical setting, can be carried out to evaluate future application with other centers, with other colleagues in Europe, in Italy and Europe. Thank you so much. Thank you for your attention.